Okay. So, what the deuce is going on here? Wait. Is this guy an enemy? I'm very confused about what's going on here and how we got to this point. Okay, we gotta switch this one. Oh, and let's knock him over. Alright. So this is a side quest set in the area for the... the first zone, but it's, the lighting's different. And there's more enemies, and this guy apparently... This guy really likes the idea of... Ow. This guy really likes the idea of just, oh, what am I even thinking? Attacking that light. There we go. Okay, my brain. My brain's catching up here. I'm gonna sprint into this hut. Anything in this hut? The answer is no. That's probably for the best. Anyway, I'm so glad that archers are never particularly well armored. Makes my life a lot easier. Hello, random person, who was not watching me murder the crap out of all of his friends. But this works out. Okay. Let me see. Nothing there, nothing there. I don't know how many items we're going to be able to find while around here. It's actually really nice playing this with completely different lighting. Okay. Boop. Ow. Okay, I got booped. Knock him down. Nope. Didn't get him down. Alright. Now we pull back. I got more range than a spear. But if he hits me first, it's moot. Do I have anybody else around here? No, but we do actually have items. Okay, so there are actually reasons for me to explore around here. That's cool. Let me see. I wanna... The problem is they changed it around just slightly, so it's kind of confusing. Where and what and who and how. And I'm pretty okay with that, but it's just like, it's messing with my brain, man. It's messing with my man brain. I don't know, sometimes I just like to think, how would this sentence sound if I, like, switch these words around? And the answer is, it always sounds dumber. I'm okay with that, but still. Okay, so do we have these, like, side cuts? Are there people hiding around here? I'm trying to cover my butt just in case I do have to go running away. One of the reasons why I can always, I could, like, cheese the crap out of all of the Oni fights is because I made sure that I actually had some room to maneuver. I don't. Yeah. Thank you, danger senses. Ow. Yeah, so there was somebody hanging out up there. I guess I can pop an elixir. And nothing over here. Okay. Yeah, I gotta remember, I don't quite have the speed. I have to do opportunism to trigger my moves here. Cause pretty much all I have to do is spin to win. There we go. Yeah! I don't get to use that very often. It's really satisfying. I just wished it worked at full range, because boy, could we do some serious damage to people. Alright, let's see. Okay, good. I do have a rifle here. And we want that rifle. Oh, hi. There's a man hiding in here. Can I get him? Nope, missed. Come on. Stop hiding in there. Are not. Okay. I don't know what's with this man's cowardice, but it's not working for him. Have you ever thought about playing through For Honor? Yeah, I probably actually will be playing through For Honor at some point. What is he doing? The only problem I have with For Honor is it's very PvP focused from what I can tell. So I've been a little bit less interested in picking up For Honor in comparison to, like, not Nioh. Nioh? Supposedly it's Nioh. Nioh. Oh, hi. But yeah, I've been a little bit less interested just because it's, you know, it's a very multiplayer-focused title, and for me, I'm all about that single-player co-op kind of gameplay. Oh, hey, a lot of the fires got put out. Anyway, so seeing as I'm pretty much out of ammo on that, Alright, so... Oh. Huh. Alright. Well, we both screwed up. You okay, guy? Alright, you look okay. Yeah, so all I have to do is get the timing right. But yeah, I'll probably look into For Honor. The only other problem I have with For Honor specifically is I'm kind of specifically... I'm not going to say I'm anti-Ubisoft. I really don't trust Ubisoft. Everything they put out, because I think For Honor is a Ubisoft game. Everything that they put out feels... I'm not going to say poisoned to me, but like... Just most Ubisoft products tend to be a little bit on the junky and bad side. You know, they might be really good games, or products or whatever, but there's just something about them, be it Uplay, be it forced multiplayer, be non-forced multiplayer, be it really anything. They all just kind of go together into making Ubisoft games scary to, like, want to cover, because, you know, there's something wrong about them, and they never really fix it. And that sucks. And it's hard for me to justify, you know, playing a lot of, this guy dies. I don't know if he had friends around there. Well, I was expecting him to have friends, but I guess no dice. Okay. Like, what's a good example? I really disliked how, like, weird and long Assassin's Creed 4 was. It just felt wrong. Or, not four. Three? Ow. Like, three had all of this, like, forced tutorial nonsense, and it sucked. There we are. Can we give him the kiss of death? Yeah, we can give him the kiss of death. I don't know if it's the kiss of death. It's the embrace of death? It's the murder brawl. Oh, hey. There's a guy here. Hello, random guy. Bye. There's just something satisfying about headshots in this game. It just feels good. I don't know. Makes me sound like a bit of a psychopath, but whatever. Okay, so these are Heroku Damas. Which I believe are the bomb. I think it's this bomb. I wish they'd just go into storage. Instead of just taking a spot in my inventory. Oh well. I'm curious where this boss is supposed to be, and if he's actually going to be much of a boss, if it's going to be multiple people, like what the dealy-do is going to be. Oh shoot, they probably moved to the shrines. Oh! I'm very confused. I heard a man... I don't see him. Oh, there he is. Hi! Well, it works out. Unfortunately, I have to spin the chain up whenever I attack. I don't know. I always feel like the chain's a bit of a... I'm gonna say, like, a bit of a liability in quick fights. At some point, I might switch gears. Oh. Huh. I guess we have to do all of this in one shot. It's okay, we've been getting a ton of elixirs anyway, so I guess it's not a big deal. Oh, shoot, I should be paying attention. Okay, that really is not much of a... Ow! Whoa! Hi. Bye! Alright. There we go. Oh, and we got the maximum familiarity with our... Yep! We got maximum familiarity with our sword, which surprises me because I'm not actually using it. I guess it doesn't matter. Also, we're getting a reputation, so I should probably sit down and spend some of this fame. Let's see. Titles. There we go. Title list? No, prestige summary. Okay, here we go. So we got 2 Agio prestige points. I want to pick up some luck. And do we want life? Do we want received elemental attack damage reduced? Or... Yeah, let's go life. Alright, and we do have Ungyo. Toughness. Breaking guard. Extra key. Key is always tempting. Even if it's only like a little bit. Yeah, we'll do that. Anything that increases my like general survivability is super important. Anything that increases my maximum stamina, even more so. Ooh, there's an item over there. And anything that increases my chances of finding rare magical items, yes. There's something I actually really appreciate about this game being kind of a gear treadmill. A lot of the games are kind of games. Items, abilities are interchangeable, but it's one of those where there are definitive like positives and negatives. Freaky birds. I have no idea where the leader man is supposed to be. I can't imagine it's this guy. Boop. Boop. Well, yeah, I don't think that was the boss. I'm a little bit worried, obviously. Just because... Oh. Nope, he didn't notice me. Okay, yeah, there's a guy sitting over there. Unfortunately, it seems like a lot of the enemies in this game have particularly bad vision. Which works great for me. Oh, this guy's got 2 swords. Uh-oh. And I'm stuck at the door. Surprise! Oh, he knows how to dodge. This might be the boss. Have a bomb. Have another bomb. Have a third bomb. Have more bombs. Have other bombs. Shit, yeah, this is the boss. At least it feels like it. This guy knows what he's doing. Alright. Well, that's okay. We got poison. Works great for us. Oh, there we go. Might actually just take him out for us. I think that was it. Was that it? No? Shit. I don't know. He looked like a viable candidate. This poison's actually pretty great. Assuming that we can actually get it to trigger on an enemy. Oh, I missed. Okay, come on. A little bit more. Got him. Alright, and he's not out of stamina, which sucks. Let's see, a little bit more room. I'm actually doing fairly good. I mean, my main issue in this game is against opponents that are like big and you can't... Like, if this game was purely against human NPCs, I'd probably be okay with it just because their mechanics make sense. It's the Oni that are rough and tumble and destroy me. Okay, whatever. Let's see. Yeah, there's always a corpse here. Bloody Grave, Nishi Hironoshin. Nah, I don't recognize the name from yesterday. Let's see. So if you like games that are based on RNG loot, what's my opinion on Destiny? I like Destiny, actually. Because it's got RNG loot, but it also has, like, very definitive, like, weapons that you can kind of point to and pull from. My only problem with Destiny is it's on consoles. Apparently, Destiny 2 is supposed to be coming, Destiny 2 is only supposed to be, is actually supposed to be coming to PC, which is good, because why didn't Destiny 1 come to PC? Oh, there's another man here. Now let's piss him off. Neat thing about this game is I can technically hit and run really hard if we, like, go all the way back. Well... It's okay. I love this. I love this weapon. It's stupid. It's just like, It's the coward weapon for people that don't feel like fighting normally. That's what I am. Yeah, see, I thought that, like, really hard guy that kept blocking and dodging and whatever was gonna be the boss, but nope, doesn't look like it. Which has a lot of implications. Means we probably have to go all the way out to the beach. Boop. 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 Yeah, I'm noticing in this game a lot of enemies don't have particularly good reach. So if you wanna fight them, all you have to do is get within their reach and then back up a little bit, and they just immediately overstroke. It actually works this way with almost every enemy I've come across. That was cool. I don't have that much ammo left. Alright, and there's only one. Ow. Huh. Well. Oh. And we have more friend. And also that spear is freaking out. I think it still is. Could be wrong. Alright. Anyway. Oh, perfect. Perfect. Oh, I love this move. Even if it doesn't kill enemies, it is so satisfying to use. It'd be nice if I could, like, power it up. I don't know. Anyway. Let's see. It's actually kind of fun that the mission is just like, you know that area you went through on that last mission? Go through it again, backwards. I don't know. It's lazy, but at least they switched up the lighting. I don't know, for me, that's a big thing. It's just satisfying this way. Okay. Oh, there's a man here. Well, hello! Uh-oh. He's got an axe. Really don't like fighting axe dudes. I guess it's not that big of a deal, though. Is he dead? Nope, he's not dead. I really need to, like, get a stomp attack. I mean, obviously, we've got one, but I want an attack that is just like, there's an enemy on the ground. I'm just going to kind of kick him around a little bit. Instead, we give him time to get back up like an honorable samurai. Alright, we want to switch to the bow for this one. Is there a reason to go up here? In fact, doesn't look like we can go up here. Alright. Oh, that kind of solves things. Oh, it looks like they've also limited my range of movement a little bit. Oh, that's fair. Got anybody around here? We do not. Well. Huh. I wonder if he's gonna bring friends. I kinda hope he won't. But at the same time, I'm not... Yeah, nope. He did not alert any of his friends. He coulda. He shoulda. But he did not. You know, I kind of wish we actually had, like, I want to say, I really wish we had, like, abilities that would, like, attack enemies from behind. Like, with Dark Souls, there were a fair amount of, like, assassination attacks. Which were really awesome to use, because what you could do is, you know, you could... like, position well and stab an enemy in the back if you're lucky. Which always felt, like, really good to me. Unfortunately, this game doesn't do that. Like, what I want to be able to do is, like, from behind, wrap my chain around somebody's neck and murdinate them really hard. I mean, I got the jump on them. I should have that luxury. Is he sprinting? He's sprinting. Dumbass is sprinting. Well, I'm not gonna say that that wasn't a fatal maneuver, but that was a pretty fatal maneuver. Eh, I guess he ain't dead yet. Correction. Alright. I don't know. I might actually keep with this. I mean, my biggest problem with Souls-likes is sheerly one very simple thing. The bosses always end up being, like, super frustrating. Oh, you look pretty bossy. Yeah, he looks pretty bossy. Okay, well, he's distracted with that. Poison. Shit! Okay. One. Two. We want to get him poisoned if we can. Yeah, if this guy's the boss, and he very much looks like it, and I can get him poisoned, that works great for me. Is that enough to get him poisoned? Doesn't look like it. This sucks. Well, it's okay. Coward tactics win the day. It'd be nice if I could get him to fall down that cliff. Ow. Okay. Let's run away for a little while. This guy hurts real bad. Oh, interesting. He lost me. Well, when in doubt, shoot him in the head. You can headshot the guy. Oh, that's great. All right. We're done with the mission. Now what? Oh, I guess we go out this way. Okay. Are they regular people or something similar to Dark Souls where they're hollow? No, these are regular people. These are just assholes. There are people that are similar to hollows in Dark Souls. Okay, so that's the way out. Let's explore around a little bit. There might be some, like, loot caches or secret, like, sub-boss thing. I don't know. But yeah, no, these are just regular bandits slash military people. Oh, nope. Guess we can't go that way. There's our answer. Let's see. But this game is extremely long. First 10 hours are just the beginning. First 3 hours are just the beginning, unless you're really slow. And or don't know what you're doing. I don't know. Hard to say. But yeah, no, they're just regular humans that are kind of stupid because AI programming, I guess. Okay, marvelous work. Just as I expected, the villagers were overjoyed. They certainly have met with a string of misfortunes of late. Let us hope this was the last. Alright, so we also get the Rare Item Seeker title. I really wish the titles, instead of giving you just a title, I actually wish every single title you got gave you a different effect. Like, Rare Item Seeker would increase the chance. I don't know, it'd be nice. So, Yokai Close Combat. Now, let's do Durability. Ah, yes, you will not be asked it again. That's nice. And Reader Earned. Ooh. Toughness Item Drop Rate. Okay, good. So, it's not going to ask me anymore. That's nice. Okay, so, we can do... Let's get out of this. So, we can do Isle of Demons. We can do Death to Bandits. So, at this point, if I redo them, we get less of a reward. But we can't redo them. Well, that's nice. We also have Deep in the Shadows, which I think I'm fairly certain I know which one that is. Why does it have an exclamation mark? Oh, because I'm missing two of the little shrine dudes. I should probably look into that. Anyway, no, we want to do starting point shrine. Okay, we want to level up. I got a fair amount of Amrita for that. Alright, so we could do Dexterity. I could just keep pumping it into Dexterity. Crazy ninjutsu time. Is there a reason not to? Yeah, there probably is. Let's do 2 into Dexterity. 2 into Heart. It's always a little bit tempting to put points into Body, but it gets me almost nothing. It'd be better for me to put points into stamina and work on my equipment max. Yeah, let's do it this way. Okay, so we've done that. Kadama Blessing. I think we're still set on Healer Blessing, yeah? Yeah. I think this is actually going to be one of my major grumbles about this game. I like the elixirs, but I wish they dropped, like, constantly, so you generally had... Well, maybe not constantly, but frequently. I guess it doesn't matter so much, and eventually I'm going to be able to get a 25% drop rate increase on that. We might also want to look into some of the other blessings. I like those. Anyway, So let's ready some jutsu, because I've got a fair amount. Actually, let's see if I can level up some jutsu while I'm here. I also haven't looked into combos that much. So, to get some of these, we need Way of the Ninja. Okay. I guess we should probably figure that one out. Where is that? Exactly? Dojo. Way of the Ninja, Novice. Alright. Ah, William, you have come. If you're interested, I'd be happy to teach you what I know of the Way of the Ninja to you. Oh, I know you are strong, but soon you will face enemies against whom a frontal attack will only lead to disaster. A ninja, however, strikes from behind. Our strength lies in controlling the battlefield itself. Mastering our techniques will make you a greater warrior yet. So yeah, I guess I gotta do this to unlock some new moves. There's a weapon-affected cannon. Interesting. Oh yeah, there's a cannon. I've used it before. It does thousands of damage. Only if you hit an enemy in the head, or the face, or whatever. But yes, I've used it before to great effect. Okay. Locks of hair can be used to obtain various types of skill points. I guess it wants me to use it. Alright. Use skill points to learn the skill option in... to learn a skill. So which skill? Okay, so it wants me to learn Shuriken Shooter. Probably. You can ready ninjutsu and Omiya magic at the shrine. Use them. Kinda know these things. It'd be almost nice if I could just switch past these. Okay, anyway, so it wants me to ready jutsu, which we've done before, and blinding shell. Gotcha. Oh. And then assigned to them as shortcuts to items. Forgot that part. Okay, there we go. Okay, we killed one of them. Nope, we didn't kill one of them. Okay, now we kill one of them. I'm just gonna chuck many shurikens at this guy. Not that it really matters. Okay, there we go. Mission complete. Wow, that was fast. So, I wish you had told me just, like, kill them in any way you can. Because I was like, am I supposed to do something specific here? Am I supposed to use up all of my abilities? It didn't matter. Okay, so this should unlock some new ninjutsu for me. Or ninjutsu upgrades. I really like the skill tree in this game. Like, I like Dark Souls' leveling system, but I really like the fact that I have some character customization beyond that in this. You know, special moves and interesting abilities and stuff like that. I don't know, it just feels really good to me. Okay, you have the knack for this, William. With this level of diligent practice, you will undoubtedly master more difficult techniques. I'll impart further secrets another time. Do not neglect your training in the meantime. Alright, so anyway, we got some stuff, but that's okay. Okay, we don't have anything. Speaking of ninja locks, okay, yeah, here we are. Block of hair from a young ninja who fell in battle, used to obtain one ninja skill point. Okay. I'm just gonna use these, there's no reason why not to. Let's see, do we have anything else for... Nope. Oh, that's fine. We also have small spirit stones, but I don't think I'm gonna be using them. Okay, so, learn skills. So now we have the ability... So, we still can't upgrade any of these, which sucks, but we can get the other things. Poison Shuriken. Ooh. Ooh, Blister Beetle Powders, Antitoxin skills, not so much so. Huh. Lightman Concealment, those look kind of interesting. What else have we unlocked? Paralysis Shuriken, Blinding Shell... Exploding Shuriken, Fire Shuriken. Let's see. Ooh, increases the number of arrows that can be carried by two. And bullets that can be carried by two. Yeah, that's useful. What else we got? Ooh, Tiger Running Scrolls. Increases your run and dash speeds. Smoke ball, not so much though. Oh, here we go. For enemies who do not notice you, use triangle to perform a powerful attack from behind. So, I guess we do have that. Composure. Press triangle or square when guarding against an armed human enemy to take their weapon and perform a counterattack. Can only be used when barehanded. Let's pass on that one. Alright, let's see. What do we want to do? The poison thing sounds kind of neat. All these skills seem really cool. I just don't know if any of them are good. Or bad. Hard to say. So we have kick the enemy. Flux. What's flux do? No. Mostly useless. We could do this one. High stance only throws the Kusarigama's sickle at an enemy and draws them close. Or propels you towards them if they're large. It's a little scary. I'm a little bit leery about using that one. Just because it could screw me up real bad. Here and there. Okay. Most of the rest of these seem kind of moot. Anyway, let's check out this. Quick draw attack can only use when sheathed. Not that useful. Combo with the roundhouse kick. At some point, I should learn how to combo. But honestly, I'm usually not that, I'm not that brave here. Oh, these are dual swords. We're not looking for dual swords right now. So we don't want EI. We don't want these. Disperses key from your swords. Stun surrounding enemies. That's interesting. Let's see. Follows up a combo with a slash. Stepping back. Okay, here we go. High stance only. High stance only. Combo with a jumping slice. I should look into what combos we want to do. Oh, but I don't do combo. I don't do high stance with sword. It's too slow for me. Sword is my quick thing. Kick that launches the enemy up. Finishes with a downward strike. Oh, but that's low stance only. Mid stance. I'll try that, even though it seems risky to me. Okay. Oh, I see. So we've got this one versus the other. I don't know. I'll look into these at a later date. The problem is, ultimately, I don't know what most of them do. And I can spend forever looking at these things, but I don't know. Anyway,